Bins Hall, Cedar Rapids, Iowa, part-time reseller, multiple platforms. My name is Jess. Welcome to Thrifting is My Beach. Let's get started. I want to clarify, I went on a Sunday. It's very important which day you go. I haven't gone on a Sunday in a very long time, especially to this location. I recommend not going on a Sunday. It was crowded, more competition. They weren't rotating the bins as frequently. I think I saw three rotations, maybe four. And I was there for probably four and a half hours. This location is $1.49 per pound, if you're not familiar. This bin's location has only been open since July, and it is currently September 2021. So it's a newer location. The location was still clean, but people, I guess, weren't as pleasant. They were aggressive. And even though there's COVID, I'm from Illinois, and we have a mask mandate. However, in Iowa, it's a little bit different. There, people don't wear masks. I wore a mask. I'm currently 17 weeks pregnant. And even though I am vaccinated, I just want to keep as safe as possible. So let's get started. You do have to wear gloves at this location as well, which kind of, I personally don't like wearing gloves. I understand it protects you from broken glass, but I like feeling materials because I sell clothing. I also sell hard goods. I'm sending a lot of this to ThredUp, and I will let you know which pieces those are, but let's go ahead and get started. Also, before I get too in-depth and forget, please like this video. It really helps, and comment down below what your favorite item was from this haul. Okay, and I guess subscribe if you like reseller content. Let's get started with a bang. All right, so I saw this, and I only went through picked over bins. I tried looking through new bins, and people were just in my space, and I didn't like it. So this was in a picked over bin. I could tell by the quality and the hardware. It's got a really cool like lock that this may be something. If you look closely, it's also all the hardware is branded, which is an indicator of better quality. This piece is in great condition. So I opened it up, and I had not heard of this label. I don't sell purses very frequently, but I was specifically looking for shoes and purses for ThredUp. This was also inside of it, which is an indicator it may be something. And I haven't actually opened it all the way. I will let you know, I looked this up on ThredUp to see if it was worth it. And they say that they retail for like $300 to $400. And this is a larger bag, so they should have it retail pretty well. It says it is Italian, artisan craftsmanship, high quality. That's it. So keep an eye out for this brand if you see it and you're considering ThredUp. They price it well. I didn't check the resale value to sell it personally, just because I don't really care to. So the interior is also very clean. It's got its logo on the interior. It's got two separate huge pockets. I mean, this thing is massive. This is like a good mom purse because you can throw in kids' toys, snacks, all the good stuff. I do not like carrying a diaper bag and a purse. It's just not very practical for me. So, okay. First time finding these. I know bins locations vary, but this bins location bands together their shoes. So they are most of the time not separated. So this is Mojave's. They are slippers, and they are known for being wool, and these liners are removable, so they're easily washable. We all know that we love our slippers a little too much, and they stink. So, well, I guess it depends, but our family has smelly feet, so there you go. I have never found this, but a previous famous reseller, who I will not mention, brought these to my attention a couple years ago. So, another bread and butter item. I think a couple years ago, these sold better than they currently do. This is a very light lilac. It is very pretty. Well, not pretty, but it's like cozy. I like the color. It's pretty big. I think it's an extra large. Barefoot Dreams, you guessed it. I'm thinking people passed on this because the tag, they didn't want to take the time to look at the tag. But I can simply throw in a stitch in like 2 minutes. And it's an extra large. Great size. I think I've sold one of these before for $40. But it was a smaller size, and it wasn't this really popular purple color. So I will put comps in the corner for you guys, just because I like to show you my haul, but I also like to kind of give you guys an idea of the range. And these comps are specifically for eBay. I sell on Poshmark. Mercari, all those places, but, ooh, this one's kind of heavy. I did pass, I will let you guys know. So my business model has changed. I'm trying to be more selective. So items I'm selling myself, I do not want just like $20, $25 flips. This piece is a Tigna Nello, and ThredUp does not price these very well. This is in very good condition. It has large zipper pulls, and they retail for over $100. I sell mine between $30 and $40. So because of the condition and the color, I will probably list this one. I'll look at the certain style, but between $30 and $50. I probably should have passed on this because this is my old model. If I could make like $20 on something, I would pick it up at the bins. I just fell in love with the color and the stitching detail of like the crochet lace. It is Victoria's Secret, which I sold all the time when I first started reselling 5 years ago. And I'm just trying to get away from it now because the, you know, it's just a small flip. I have three little kids and I don't get to devote as much time as I want to reselling. So I'm trying to be more selective. This, I love the buckle detail and the yellow color. It seems like a great color for fall. However, if it's going to thread up, it probably won't get processed until Christmas. I'm going to be sending out probably 5 kits. This is Kenneth Cole Reaction. Doesn't resell very well, but I think thread up prices are decent. And the bins, like I said, is $1.50 a pound. So I'm guessing this weighed 2 pounds. So it's nice. It's in good condition. I need to clean up a little bit. I use a wet wipe and then some leather conditioner. I always check the handles to make sure that they are not cracked. And I check the interior because thread up, you know, obviously wants to sell a purse in great condition. So I steer clear of ones that are not in good condition. Okay, here's a little trinket box. I meant to look up comps on this, but here is this. It is a gold toned metal. I believe this is 9 spacing. I've sold this stuff all the time, and it may just be a style. It is stamped Japan on the bottom. They had this at the retail store for Goodwill for $5.88, and I got it. It is red velvet lined. Unsure of the decade. Hummel, H-U-M-M-E-L. I sell their stuff all the time, but I'll lift up this sticker. I believe Hummel marks their items. I will do Google Lens search to verify, but just a cute little picture of a boy and girl under an umbrella. And I'm trying to, I can't tell what this material is. It's not a stone. It's man-made, I believe, probably just metal. All right, so that's a little piece. This strap, it's so funny. I got a purse that was missing. It's just a vegan leather black, like a crossbody strap. I always pick these up when I see them because I get purses that don't have straps. And I have a great example to show you soon. This is something, I have a whole bag of these in the kitchen. I forgot to grab them. I probably spent $5 on a reusable bag filled with these 90s Fisher-Price pirates and like knights and accessories. They're all together in a bag, and some were marked, some were not. I did a quick search and believe that they will be profitable. Okay. There goes one bag. I think we've got like 5 more to go. And then as a bonus, I'm going to show you some stuff from the local retail Goodwill. Hadn't been to before. We decided when we took our lunch break that we were overwhelmed with people and we wanted to change up the scenery. So we ate lunch and then we decided to go to the local Goodwill. And so I have some regular price stuff to show you as well, but that's separate. Show you that at the end. We have some Tory Burch. They are just some plain black thong sandals with like 1¼-inch platform. And I had to dig for the mate. These were separated, but looks like, I don't think that was a Goodwill sticker. It might have been. Oh, yep. Look, they were trying to sell these for $14.99 or $15.99. And it's funny because they code their stuff And initially it was $4.99 because it was the four and then the color. And then they raised it to the 15p. So they didn't sell. But they're in decent condition. You know, someone will want these. And I don't know. These are probably worth like $30. But Tory Burch always brings a lot of traffic to my store. And if not, I'll sell them on ThreadUp. But I was actually checking comps for ThreadUp, like how they just price Tory Burch items. Because I have a blouse that hasn't sold yet. And it wasn't that high. So I will sell Tory myself. This was the first item that I got when I looked in the bins. It is white. I know, it's white. I might have, should have passed. It is the newer White House Black Market. And it's new tags. It did take me a second because it did not have the brand. But here's the tag. It retailed for $60. So I will remove the retail sticker. They are still very white. However, I saw like a dust line somewhere that probably just needs to be spot cleaned. So I'll probably only make realistically like $5 off of those with ThreadUp, and that's completely fine. Like I said, I took a big break from ThreadUp, so I'm just sending stuff in that I'm taking a guess, low buy-in cost, so low risk. This caught my eye. It's a mock neck. The color is rust orange, which is very, very popular for fall. And it is, it almost looks custom. It has all this, I don't know what you call it, like yarn embellished, or not embellished, embroidered. Is it called crewel? I don't know. But it also has beads, like gems on it. And it's by, look this brand up in the, oh my hair is a mess. And the comps weren't that great, but I was confused because this style is completely different. And it is 50% acrylic and 50% wool, but it's in a different language. So I must be, I'll have to do a little bit of research. I don't know if it's a European brand. That's what I'm guessing. And you can tell it's a wool blend. It's slightly itchy. But, so yeah, it's, I probably should have held it up a little bit further back. It also has some on the back. And it's like an oversized chunky pullover sweater. So I will sell that one myself. I'll probably list it for like $50. They'd said it would fit like a small to a large. Excuse me. Also, side note, they take reusable bags like these, and they have them at the checkout for people just to get for free. And I love some good reusable bags. This is a brand Cyrus. I will I'm going to send this in to ThreadUp. This brand does not resell very well. However, it is a plus size. Plus size does amazing on ThreadUp. What I usually do is risk it and I raise it above the 50% where you can get a penalty if it doesn't sell. But this is so lightweight. It weighed, I paid like a dollar for it. It's just a sleeveless hooded cardigan, like open front. And it's very basic, but it's plus size. And I'm going to risk it for that one. Here we have something that is too large to show you guys. I do very, very well selling linens, especially these were very popular in the 90s, the fringe tapestry blankets, throws, whatever you're going to call them. This one has, I think it's a holiday one with some stars and bears. And I think this one has like a halo around it. I'm sitting too close, but I always look on the back because it usually has the like ironed on sticker for the brand, and you want to look for made in USA. I stay away from the modern pieces, but I will pick up this one, American Weavers. I can usually sell these for $50 to $75, and this one is made in the USA. I always look for that. You know, I should have separated my piles from, like, ThreadUp. Actually, I'm going to go back through here and do that really quick just because we aren't very deep into it. Because I have so much stuff that needs to go to ThreadUp. I got boxes. I've used the medium extra strength boxes from Walmart. They seem to be the most affordable. They're like, what, $2.50 or something like that. They're out a lot at Walmart, though. I finally got, like, four today. Also, I finally switched to metal straws, and it's actually cold for my drink, and I really like it. It's the small things. Because they make a mess. Okay, what else do we have? This brand is underrated. If you saw on Facebook, these, for some reason, I don't know if it was just luck or what, but they get tons of views and stuff. It is Prevo, which is by Clarks. It is a comfort shoe. And I think I'm just going to send these into ThredUp. Comfort shoes do really well for me there. Like, really well. It's got a good tread. Yep. ThredUp, it will go. I pick up this random burlap flower. I really liked the style, and it is magnetic. I'm guessing it was an accessory to a purse or something. But my husband recently started crafting wood pieces and went to a flea market and had a little stand last week. And we may start putting some of his items on Etsy as he enjoyed himself and had a good sale, well, good sales at the flea market. So that may go on something he makes. So this is nice and fuzzy. I believe it's Angora blend. It is vintage. It's by La Vogue. 80s is my guess, maybe early 90s. It is made in Hong Kong, 50% lamb's wool, 40% angora, and 10% nylon. This is so, so, so soft. This came with a matching skirt. This one is slightly pilly. It looks like somebody washed it with something that was darker. This should probably be hand washed. However, I have a sweater shaver and definitely will give that new life. Here is a plus size plaid skirt, perfect for fall, accordion pleated, midi length. Midi length. Love the colors. No anterior tags. Oh, take that back. Here's a union tag. Union made in the United States. And these sometimes, well, if they're older, can be used to help date clothes. I did do a stretch because it is larger and I thought maybe the elastic was stretched out, but there is no crunch. Listen for the crunch. Hear the crunch. You may want to put it back because it will, the elastic will need replaced. Here's a vintage cardigan. Love the color and print. This is brunette. If you are not familiar with vintage, the brands typically don't matter. Usually it's based on style, material content, stuff like that. It is faded, but it says 100% Orlon. I think it's Orlon. I don't know. Acrylic. So it's an acrylic cardigan. Love colors. It's like an olive green and a mustard yellow. Let's see, is it men's or women's? It is a zip front with a metal zipper. So I don't know if it's men's or women's. Not like it matters because we all wear men's and stuff. It's by the brand. The zipper is NYNCO. Have not seen that zipper before. So yeah, just a nice print. With that one, it's just acrylic. I'll probably list it for $50. I do really well with cardigans, especially men's. Excuse me. Gosh. Not having very good manners. I'm going to send this to ThredUp. Probably just get $5 for it. It's just some pull-on J. Jill Pont slim leg pants. I just do not like photographing these, and because of the pattern on them. We'll see. Then I found some, I think these were wool, like charcoal gray, medium Eileen Fisher pull-on pants. Ooh, look at, you know, I said do the crunch test. Hear that? Okay, so those are a no-go. They'll be re-donated or, yeah, I'm not really into crafts right now, but that would be a good to like use the material because it is wool. This, I actually currently don't know the brand, but it is logo marked everywhere. It's a girl's rash guard swimsuit. Here's the brand. Put in the comments down below if you know. At first that was Zella, but I don't think that's their logo. It's also branded on the zipper, like on the actual metal, which is not very common. And the quality felt really nice. The stitching is impeccable. So, let me know in the comments if you know what that brand is. It is a girl's. I'd probably say like a girl's 8, maybe 10. They always look so small. And then here is The sack gets priced pretty well at ThredUp. It's pretty simple. Just a black and brown leather shoulder bag. There's the little key charm. So that will go to ThredUp as well. My back is already hurting me. Oh. Okay, here's another exciting find. I found Kate Spade in a dug through bin. So I'm gonna try to get it. It's zebra print, which I think has kind of made a comeback this year. I like the, it's like cognac. I forget the name of that brown, but I really like the color. Pretty simple, but fun pop. I like the hardware. And it has a notorious green polka dot inside. See Kate Spade. And then it's got the little details of the spade. It's clean inside. I think this is an older style. There is a little watermark right there. I'm going to use some leather conditioner and see if it makes it more even tone, because there are a few light little spots there, but I'm going to try it on ThredUp. I think they priced Kate Spade pretty good. Some UGG clogs. These need to be reshaped a little bit, so all I do will be put some stuffing in it. You can put a towel over it and run your steamer quickly over it, not to damage the leather, and make sure the towel is damp that you place on these, and it helps erase the creases. I did it on the last pair, and I think I have those priced at $35. These have an actual great tread on them, so I will probably price them for a little bit more, and the inside is still really fluffy. Sometimes you'll get them, and like the person's foot is super indented. So, and these are a size, if they were my size, I'd probably keep them, because I love UGG slippers. Size 7. Women, size 7. Yeah. I probably paid $3-$3.50 for those. Okay, this one I got because it felt like a very quality bag. I could not find a brand. It is genuine leather. I love the color. It's kind of like a metallic sheen with the knot detail. It's a great size, but I'll show you the inside tag. It's just simply this made in Mexico genuine leather tag. It kind of threw me for a loop because it feels like a well-made bag, but there is no brand. So because of its leather, I think ThredUp will obviously put this as like either assorted or unbranded, but we'll test it out. They might not even take it, who knows, but it's in really good condition. You guys, used underwear, vintage. I will only buy, and I've actually never sold women's used vintage underwear. The lace is sticky. I'm gonna try to save this, and I'll tell you why. These satin gold label Victoria's Secret undies have a following. I haven't checked comps for such a long time, but I've been looking out for these. However, I think the elastic has either gotten too hot or something. And I didn't notice this, otherwise I would have passed on them, but the elastic is leaving a sticky residue on my fingers, so, oh my goodness, I'll have to see if I can save those. I'll put comps up in the corner. But somebody had a bag of underwear, so yes, I grossly went through it and got these. I think they generally sell for like $30 a piece. This one is Silk Reflections. Yeah. And they were all clean. Like, I'm not going to pick up nasty undies, but here's another pair of Victoria's Secret. These are the cotton ones. And I think those are it for undies. Found a vintage. It reminds me of a tablecloth needlepoint sundress. Oops, I'll show you the cute part. Right here, and obviously if you want to expose yourself a little bit, I think it would cover your nipple. Yeah, it's up to you. But just a nice white dress, vintage, no anterior tags at first because this style is kind of trending, but I looked at the inside stitching. It's a handmade vintage piece. Don't know what I'll ask for that yet. I got this on Jack and Ryan's channel. They're saying that Men's Urban Outfitters does really well. And I got this because of the print. I'll try to zoom in so you can see, but I think it has some women on it that are not dressed. Almost like, they're not cherubs because these are, well, here's one. Here's like, almost like Virgin Mary holding up a child. I don't know, but this print made me think that it could have value. I don't know. Or a sought-after style, and it's a men's extra large. I got a vintage cardigan. Probably 60s or 70s. Maybe 60s. Acrylic. It is by Kmart. Oh my goodness. I'll have to go to Vintage Guild and check the label, because this does look pretty old. And loved the colors, the style. It's open front. And it has the original tie. A lot of times you find them, they don't have the original tie. So, I don't even know. It's a medium. I don't know if it's intended for a man or a woman. But like I said, it doesn't really matter. I generally list most of my stuff as women's. But the men's cardigans, if they're boxy, I will list them as men's. Where is my hair tie? Ugh. Don't have one on me right now. I got this one based off of style. I generally don't pick up White Stag. I think this is who it's by. Oh, not White Stag. This is Blair. There are no shoulder pads in it, so I don't know. It is made in the USA. I think this is an 80s tag. Maybe they just cut the shoulder pads out, but I got it because of the oversized blazer. The colors are absolutely gorgeous. And it is not lined. It's an unstructured blazer, but it almost feels like wool. Yeah, acrylic recycled wool. Yeah, beautiful piece. I love it. And it is a vintage size 38. That's like measured in men's. I don't know. Don't think Blair made men's clothes. I got this because it's an extra large, and who knows, I may keep it for myself. Although I don't think I can hide a baby bump right in that. Well, not like I really need to hide a baby bump, but cover it. I love the style. Love the sleeve. Look at that. I'll probably just list it myself, even though I shouldn't be selling lower dollar stuff. $25, $20, probably $20. Got this for thread up. I forget. There's some designer that makes these bags now. It's been renamed. I see a little spot, but I'm hoping I can spot clean that off. This one is by Comely. I think that's how you pronounce it. Just a handbag. It's got the feet. Pretty simple. That will be going to thread up. I don't know how they're going to label that one. Love, love, love this. It is just Susan Graver, which I don't sell myself, but I will send this in a thread up because it's a jacket. And I think this will photograph so well. Plus, I think it's plus size. Yeah. Yeah, this is a 1X, so again, I will mark this up. And I believe this is... Oh, no, I thought it was reversible, but it is not reversible. Here's a vintage blouse. I got it because if it was simple, I probably would have passed. But it's got like a little, like a thin pussy bow necktie. And it's got a really neat floral print with a cuff. Just a button front, like secretary blouse. I will sell myself for like $30. I got this to sell myself. This is stuff that was popular when I was in high school. This is very Y2K. And it's in now. So I'm going to sell it. It's like a homecoming dress. Which homecoming is going on right now. So just a special event. It's a size 6. Probably. I don't know if it still would fit a size 6. It probably will. But really pretty gown. Love the neckline. It's got a little peekaboo action there. And then I got this. I think I got this for thread up too. what brand is this? Tangerine, yeah. I'm gonna mark this one up too. It's this really, it looks kind of red, but it's orange. Quilted puffer vest. It's just very trendy. It's a decent athletic brand. So I will send that in. Oh, we're getting closer. We're getting closer, guys. Thank you for sticking with me also. I do really appreciate it. I got this based off of style. Obviously, it's the wrong season, but it's a cute little plaid check bag with bamboo handles. It is a smaller size, and it is by Tiani. I'm just trying handbags, as if it was in good condition and not heapy cheapy, I picked it up. This one I need to do research on. It just seemed like a better quality sports bra. And I don't know the logo. I'll show you guys here in a second. It is one, well, it's like a, I thought that was neat. It's a front zipper sports bra, and it says one more rep, one more rep. Very clean. Like, normally white sports bras are nasty, but the logo is right here. It's a crescent moon right there. And there is a brand, but I haven't heard of it. I just grabbed it because it's so lightweight. Zaya Active. It's an XXL, which is also a great size. So I don't know. I'm guessing 20. I could be wrong. Here is the matching skirt that went with that. Oh, it's touched my face. That's lovely. That went with that Angora sweater by La Vogue. Yeah, it's lamb's wool and Angora. And it's a set. I will sell them individually. I feel like I make more money selling sets individually than selling them together. I wanted to try this out. It's a Y2K dress. So somebody was trying to sell it at a yard sale for $5. Do you remember the store? You probably need to be over 30 to remember this. the junior store Deb. It was like a cheap discount store. I would go there for, oh, it's missing a stone. Maybe I'll just remove this. Yeah, I think I'm just going to remove this because it's on one strap. But I would go there and buy all my clubbing shirts when I used to go out to the clubs. It's just like a ruched satin blue mini dress, bodycon style. It'd be very flattering. So yeah, but I noticed there is, oh, there's two stones missing. And it is on one strap. So I think I'm just going, because it doesn't really add a whole lot. So I'm just going to remove it and sell it myself. Probably for $40. Call me crazy. I know it probably retailed for that. Maybe 30 years ago. But I'll sell that myself for $40. Just giving it a shot. I typically pass on that style. But I heard from another reseller that she sells those all the time. Got this based off of style and material content. It is 100% silk. It's by Diane Gilman. I don't know if, I think this is a 90s tag. It's beaded. It's got huge those irises. I have them in my yard. I think they're irises. Yeah, really pretty. Oversized. Side slits. It's a large. This brand, I think, people always say keep an eye out for Martha's Miniatures for like their circle pageant dresses for little girls. This is a slip, but it has, somebody put bells on it with a little bow. Look at this. Oh my gosh. This, like, it's almost like a petticoat. Do you see how, and this is what you would wear under a circle dress to give it fullness. I've never seen one with so many layers. For such a little girl, too, because it's really small. What size is this? Oh, of course the size is faded, so I'll have to take measurements. Yeah. I got a pair of men's utility pants. They seem like an older style utility cargo with the flat pockets by Proper. I did not look up comps. I just kind of chanced it. Oh, I think they're military issue. There's the military issue tag. So I simply look up the stock number, like the model number. Very easy to find, but these are in really good condition. A lot of times you see them all stained up. And I do pick up older military pieces, not modern ones, but I pick up the older pieces. from like the 90s or earlier. Don't know the comps on those though. Like I said, I only comp things if I don't know. I got this. Oh my gosh, I love this scarf. It's a really big square scarf. I believe this is silk. Where did I see? There's a brand on it somewhere. Yeah, here's the brand. Feels like silk. It's by, I can't even read that. I'll just do a Google search. But yeah, it's a really pretty black and red floral with daisies and I don't know what other flowers those are. I love this bread and butter brand. It sells well for me and fast, usually within 30 days. It's a petite extra large. It is Ming Wang. I compared a lot with Misook. Not Mislook, Misook. But yeah, this one is, again, I should probably be able to get like $35 for it. Maybe more. $40. Sorry, one of my cats are outside and there's like a bunch of outside cats. And so I just want to make sure that they aren't trying to fight. Okay, I have one more bag from the outlet. And then I have a couple bags of bonus items to show you that I got from the thrift. Also from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, which is a 2-hour drive for me. The first time I got there at the bins, I went in the first two bins and found cute vintage. This is a really pretty gown, black satin with a nice puff sleeve. Like they even stuffed it. Look at that, with some tulle. And it is a floor length black satin gown. Pretty simple, but elegant. I was hoping to find some gunny sacks because I have some vintage dresses to show you in a second, but they weren't. I don't think they're gunny sacks, but like bins, you know, this thing probably weighed about a pound, so $1.50 for that. Here's something else I got that I typically pass on all the time. Got this for ThredUp, but the quality just got me. It's just Nine West, but it's in like brand new condition. It's labeled here and there's the zipper pull. It's a nice tote size, which just seems practical, and it's clean. So even if I just get like $10 for it, I'm okay. Got these that need leather condition. I sell this brand very well. I just sold a pair of pants the other day by this brand for $50 on Poshmark. And it's Ariette. They make boots too. Just like a Western wear brand. Oh, I need to put that pile over there. What is this? Oh, this is, I got that strap. Where'd the strap go? I found a black strap that needs to go right here. Oh, wait. Oh, you know what? I think I'll put the strap here and it folds down like this. Oh, that's so cute. Yeah. So it's a gray, fuzzy, faux fur Steve Madden bag. And the strap I have is longer, like it'll be a crossbody. This is very trendy, although I'm not sure what these snaps originally went to. I don't know if it went to the original strap, but there is the large zipper pull that says Steve Madden. It's in great condition. Because a lot of times you, like, the faux fur stuff will get matted. There is some wear, like, if you can see, like, some nicks and scratches on the hardware. But overall, it's a great piece. I don't know if I'll sell that myself or send it into ThredUp. I might just send it in. All right. This one I got, I don't even know the brand, L-U-Q. It's a medium. It's just trendier piece. It's got some open knit details with a knot in the front. I'm just gonna send that to ThredUp and mark it up a little bit and see what happens. It's probably a really cheap price or brand because it doesn't feel like anything special. I also got these for ThredUp based off of style, color, and size. It is just a brand called Westport. I can't remember where these are sold at, but these are a size 20W. And they are in like new condition, skinny leg. So they'll just go ThredUp and I will max the price out and just take a chance. I had to open a new ThredUp account this last week because I have two old accounts from 2020, and I can't print labels off, as I've heard a lot of other people can't print labels off. And so I had to open up a third account, which I think is absolutely ridiculous, but I can't just have my ThreadUp stuff sitting here. I don't have space. So started a new account, and I was able to print 2 expedited labels just a few days apart, which I thought you could only get 1 a month, but I was able to get 2. And then I just printed a third label today. So we'll see how I get maxed out. Here we have an Eileen Fisher thermal, or not, what is this called? Waffle knit jacket. Is it zip? No, it's a button front. Extra large. Did I say that? Yeah, extra large black. I'm probably just going to send that one in to thread up. This I meant to give to my kids. I couldn't find it. But if you are tired of Play-Doh at your house, like ours dries up, it gets stuck on the carpet. I prefer modeling dough or clay because you can leave it out and it won't dry up. And it doesn't get stuck and stuff near as much. And my kids don't eat the clay. My 2-year-old, I don't know why, but she wants to eat the Play-Doh. So I prefer clay. And it was brand new. I got this for our house. Just a cute, festive, Thanksgiving-ish fall hand towel. So I need to wash that. I meant to separate this stuff. this is not maternity, I don't think. Lil D, but I love the floral print, and it's like a swing tunic. I was going to wear it. I think it would work well as a maternity top. I just wore like black leggings underneath, like the color for fall. And I can always use decent maternity clothes. I got some shin guards. My kids are currently in soccer right now. And, you know, just in case we ever lose a pair. And these are actually by Wilson. I think ours are just generic Amazon. And then I got Mary Engelbrecht stuff. Has a really good resale value. There are a lot of collectors out there. But these I'm going to keep for myself. My mom actually sold all her stuff at a garage sale. And she could have made so much money on it if we would have known. But Mary Engelbrecht used to be sold a lot at Hallmark. These are from me to you cards with a little Scotty dog. So come November, December, I will send these out for higher dollar sale items. Here is my receipt. I went to the bins twice that day and spent about $40 at each time and got about 50 pounds to resell. So that was my 50 pound bins Goodwill outlet. Now as my bonus, I'm going to show you what I got at the regular Goodwill. I will tell you the regular Goodwill was just as crowded as the outlet. The store was really large. I can't remember which one we went to, but there's the Goodwill on as a Sunday. All the other thrift stores were closed because it was a Sunday. So everybody was there. Everybody. They had so many Halloween costumes. It was the biggest section. They had lots of kids Halloween, which I didn't have time to go through, and tons of adult. So they had a round rack of dresses, like formal dresses, and they said they could also be used as Halloween costumes, but I'll get to those in a second. I did look through the linens really quick, and I sold this brand blanket before pretty quickly for almost $100. It's Beaterlac right here. It is made in the USA. I think it's acrylic polyester blend, but this one is a very desirable print, I believe, just because of the check and the colors, and it's a decent size. So what size did I love when they include the measurements so I don't have to measure it myself. I do not like measuring blankets. I actually had a return case opened up on me on eBay. I sold a comfort, like a 70s patchwork comforter for $100. The sucker weighed 7 pounds, and I shipped it through Pirate Ship to the buyer, and I actually made like 10 bucks off of shipping. And I measured it for my measurements, I always put approximate, and I measured it at 76 inches across, and they said it measured at 74 inches across and showed a picture. And it was actually 74.5, and it depends how much you stretch a blanket, you know, because it's stretchy material. And since they opened it as an INAD item, not as a scribe case, I was obligated to accept it. And I should have clicked create my own label, but I've always only done return labels through eBay. And that sucker cost me $25 to have it shipped back to me. So it's eating into my profits quite a bit, unfortunately. And it's still for sale. Okay, enough of me blabbing. I know I talk way too much. Okay, now on to the, and these were all considered Halloween. Gorgeous. I did run across another reseller. He saw me on my phone because I was talking into eBay, checking comps. He's like, oh, you checking comps? And I said, yeah, and he's a regular there. And he was saying that apparently the Heartland of Iowa, I think that's the district, that they have, and this is just what he said, that they have a third party go through their items and buy out the higher end items and sell them. So I think it's illegal through their corporation. That's what he said. I did go through the clothing and the brands were not even as good as Central Illinois, which they should be better than what we have. So I'm not sure, but that's just what he said. So take that as you want. Here is a blue velvet, a little puff sleeve action maxi dress. I love selling this brand. There is a dry tag sticker on it, but it's Lands, which is Lands of Salzburg. This is probably from the 80s, early 90s, made in the USA. This may be 90s. It has like little faceted button details on the back right there. Great condition. I sell those from like 50 to 75. Found this really cool double-sided crew neck. What town is this? Big Mountain, Montana. Has a huge Oliver print, if you want to call it that. And then on the back as well, which made me really want it. I did pay $388 for it. However, the tag is cut out, so I will have to measure it, but it looks like a women's large, men's medium. Not sure what I will price that one at. Beautiful lavender lilac dress. Love the neckline. Check this out. Oh my goodness, like this is so freaking cute. It reminds me kind of like of an 80s quinceañera dress. And it's got the bow on the back. This one I don't think had a brand. I'm trying to think what the zipper says. Nope. Maybe it was handmade. Because a lot of times you'll see inside like either a union tag or a, yeah. I think this was handmade because they used like a thicker fabric for the arm area since your skin typically is more sensitive there. So I'm guessing this was handmade, but it's really pretty. And I paid $5.88 for that one. That's what their dresses are. Love the color and style of this piece. Oh, it's a two-piece. Did not realize that. Okay, so here's the top, and it's kind of washing this out, but this is like Kelly green color. Well, yeah, it's very green. It says dry clean only. Again, no brand name or anything. It's just a polyester. So there is, it's like an empire waist high neck. Look at that detail on the neckline. And it's also on this, like on the sleeves. This is full length. This is floor length. Really nice piece. Two piece. Great condition. I didn't see any snags or blemishes on it. And then this next one I was hoping was like an 80s guns gown, but I don't think it is. It's like blue satin and lace. Very Victorian vibes. Yeah, see, it's a vintage 78. And there's the union tag. But again, no, sadly, no brand tag. But check out this. Check out this gown. Oh my gosh. Total. Like, I'll put Victorian in the title. I'll get tons of views. This probably will sell pretty well. Around $100. Has the lace. And it's blue satin. It may sell actually for $125. Look at the bottom. It's like Southern Belle style. Absolutely gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. And then it has, I think I already said, it has the original sash. For the front, has the bow. On the puff sleeve, has a rear zipper. I'm trying to see what the back looks like. Yeah, it's pretty plain back. And that was just $5.88. Shocked. I had to be very selective at this store because they had so many vintage dresses, but they were almost $6. And I was like, eh, I'm trying to be more selective. This is for myself. It's just a Scentsy thing that you put like the wax on because sometimes mine get nasty or they fall off and break. So it's $1.88, but that was for myself. At this store, I think I spent $47. And I think this was for myself, so 45 technically. I need to set that off to the side. And one last bag, guys, and then I will let you go. I think this is kind of a longer one. Oh my gosh, 50 minutes. I had to pick this up when I was leaving the bins. It's a cute little burlap reusable tote. How cute, and it's like really collapsible. Square shape, love it. I could actually, you know what? I could actually put that flower on it. And it would make a really cute gift bag. I paid up for this piece, but I'll show you why I paid up for it. It's amazing. It is handmade, vintage, patriotic, like a centennial celebration gown, I think. Two-piece. Check out the sleeves. Amazing. It's got a rear metal white zipper. Talon. And then here's the skirt. Can't tell if it's, I don't think it's acetate, but I think a petticoat originally went under it because it's got clips that I think you clipped underneath of it, but I think it was not sold together. So it's just like a little wrap skirt that you'd want to wear a petticoat under to get the full effect. This is like what, Civil War era style. Look at that. Love this with like the cream accent of the lace. Just puts it all together so well. Show you the inside stitching because I thought maybe somebody, it might have been more of a modern piece, but no, it's true vintage with the talon zippers. There's the inside stitching. Very well made. I need to get this listed ASAP for Halloween, but that would be an awesome party dress. What else do I have in here? Oh, our leftovers from lunch. Lovely. Okay, that was my long haul. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I probably will be going back in about a month and will not be going on a Sunday, so hopefully I find better stuff. But I hope you guys enjoyed and have a thrift-delicious day. Bye.